So get ready to get crashed.
Reality TV is constantly changing as years pass. However, the audience's general fascination with home improvement shows seems unlikely to end anytime soon. Although this genre has produced many internationally acclaimed shows, it's undeniable that the success achieved by the DIY Network series of Crashers has raised the standard very high in the field. As part of this series, Yard Crashers stands out from the rest for presenting a fresh approach to what house yard renovations actually are. By leading the audience through the process of remodeling courtyards and gardens, Matt Blashaw and his team brought new life to people's landscapes for over a decade. After being on air for so long, it's only expected that many people want to know more details about the show's important factors, such as who pays for the renovations and how much they actually cost. So, is the show really free of charge, or do homeowners pay to get the work done? Get ready, because in this vid, we'll reveal all the details regarding Yard Crashers' finances. Whatever the reason behind its success is, there's no denying that Yard Crashers' light-hearted humor and safe entertainment was a big reason people loved it so much. Nonetheless, no matter how good a reality TV show is, there are always certain aspects of it that are questioned sooner or later. In this case, the most common doubt that comes to people's minds with regards to Yard Crashers is whether or not the renovations in the show are really free. The answer isn't actually very complicated. Following reports made by homeowners featured in the show, it's made clear that not only does Yard Crashers not charge them for the labor costs of the renovations, but that the materials, furniture, and appliances are indeed free as well. These conditions actually apply to every Crasher show. As affirmed by former series participant Bill Cunningham, not only was his family not charged for remodeling the property, but the show's production staff even paid for the food consumed by the team and family. It's known that many local shops exchange supplies and appliances in return for being promoted in the series, though big parts of the operations are still financed by the producers. All in all, it sounds like a good deal for everyone, assuming of course that the payback for the producers is the resulting popularity of the series. It's already too obvious that the homeowners featured in Yard Crashers are more than fortunate. Getting a top-notch renovation of their courtyard and not paying anything for it is indeed pure good luck, especially for people who can't afford these types of services otherwise. Knowing that this sounds too good to be true, you're probably wondering, where's the catch, right? While the Yard Crashers crew does everything for free, they don't take responsibility for the taxes related to the project. This is why the production staff usually files a 1099 tax form invoicing the participants for the renovation's costs, which vary depending on how extensive the work done is. Even if receiving an invoice with these expenses isn't ideal for anyone, thinking of it as an investment might do the trick, as in the end, the participant's property value increases by at least 3 times what's paid in taxes. Though the whole financial factor of Yard Crashers has been cleared up, that doesn't stop people from distrusting other aspects of the show, such as its legitimacy. While it's guaranteed that indeed every Yard Crasher renovation is real, the audience couldn't be faulted for believing that the show has at least some staged and scripted scenes. This becomes especially suspicious since at the beginning of every episode, Matt Blashaw coincidentally happens to find a homeowner willing to renew their courtyard in a random store. So, is this real? While it isn't confirmed or denied that this specific part of the series is faked, a former participant in Yard Crashers branch show House Crashers confessed online of having cheated the way into being successfully picked for the show. Apparently, he and his spouse had known the exact store the show staff was going to visit that day, thanks to a friend who worked with the crew. After being picked and interviewed by the host, the production crew eventually visited their house, and they were selected. While this affirmation doesn't prove Yard Crashers is staged, it makes it evident that with the necessary connections and a bit of luck, it wasn't too hard to be picked by them, putting a show with an otherwise clean scandal record under a not-so-bright light. Many long-time devoted fans of Yard Crashers surely remember Ahmed Hassan, the show's first host, who appeared in it from its premiere in 2008. Ahmed is well-remembered for more than just being the show's original host, though. While his professional career in the home improvement industry started a couple of decades ago, his interest in the field dates back to when he was still a little kid, helping his father in their garden. Ahmed grew up to be what he described as a people server, for being able to talk a lot and convince others through his words. That's what led him to become a TV host in the first place. Though he'd had small roles in several DIY network shows, his big opportunities came with the premiere of Yard Crashers and of Turf Wars, a spin-off competitive series which he hosted for 2 seasons. Unfortunately, his good time on the DIY network eventually came to an end. In 2011, he openly expressed his desire to make Yard Crashers a more varied show, which wasn't taken very lightly by the producers and led to his firing, though the network simply affirmed that his contract hadn't been renewed. Ahmed was replaced by Matt Blashaw, who in 2016 took a break from it, leaving the spot open for Chris Lampton. As with his fellow hosts, Chris has an extensive career in landscape building. However, what is really more impressive is his career as a TV personality, having appeared in such shows as The Bachelorette in 2010. Though he didn't end up dating the show's main star, a chance of destiny led him to meet his now wife Peyton through the series. Afterwards, Chris hosted several home improvement shows, including Going Yard and Best Ever Three Houses, before joining Yard Crashers. Although it was always made clear that Chris's presence in the show wasn't going to be permanent, he added an air of stability during the season he was in it. However, following the show's hiatus in 2017, Chris did join the landscape building show Lawn & Order and then Home United, a problem-solving show for couples which he co-hosted with his wife Peyton. Nowadays, Chris is a judge in Clipped, a show hosted by Martha Stewart which challenges its competitors to build the best ornamental-shaped trees. Knowing how popular Ahmed Hassan was, the audience was obviously flabbergasted when he left Yard Crashers in 2011. However, the show moved forward with Matt Blashaw as its host, and perhaps unexpectedly, his popularity matched that of Hassan. Prior to Yard Crashers, Matt already had a prolific career on TV. As an actor, he debuted in the 1996 movie The Ringmaster, followed by a small role in the series De Resta. During the next decade, he appeared in some low-budget movies, before officially debuting as the host of Project Extreme in 2009, which preceded his work in several home improvement series, before joining Yard Crashers in 2011. Nonetheless, just when the audience thought Matt was going to stick with the show a long time, in April 2016, Matt announced that he was temporarily leaving to focus on his real-life business, as concurrently, Matt also appeared in the time-consuming HGTV series Vacation House for Free. In 2016, Matt joined Ellen's Design Challenge as an expert carpenter, and the next year, he went on to appear in DIY Ultimate Retreat, which to date is the last show he's appeared in, fortunately for his longtime Yard Crashers fans, who wanted him to renovate their garden or courtyard. Matt Blashaw hasn't left the business. As seen on his Instagram account, Matt not only still works as a landscape builder, but operates as a contractor. His business, Blashaw Residential, offers remodeling services to its clients, in addition to acting as a realtor for selling and buying properties in Kansas. Although Matt admittedly confesses his desire to eventually return to TV, for now, putting his full-time attention to his business is his priority. Of course, this is good news for those who still want him in Yard Crashers, but there's still more. Matt's personal life has taken a turn for the better, with his marriage to Lindsay Archer, whom he coincidentally met on the set of Yard Crashers back in 2015. It seems that the couple clicked quickly, which is only expected considering both of them are expert landscape builders and designers. Matt and Lindsay tied the knot in late 2017, and in July the next year, the couple welcomed their son, Jace William. TV star salaries will always be a topic people will be interested in, especially if these are kept in secrecy, including those involved in reality-type series. While HGTV is normally open in revealing financial details about its celebrities, the same couldn't be said about its associated channel, DIY Network. The fact that the latter is evidently more discreet about the finances makes it hard for the general public to even get an idea of how much their favorite TV stars earn. However, considering Yard Crashers usually had quite a generous budget to work with, as did its fellow Crasher series, we can assume the filming and operational crews earn more than decent salaries. When it comes to the show's hosts, it becomes more evident that their salaries working for the network were quite good, but still secret. For their part, Ahmed Hassan and Chris Lampton now have an estimated net worth of over $1 million each. Meanwhile, Matt Blashaw has an estimated net worth of close to $2 million, not only resulting from his career on TV, but from his real estate business as well. Being offered the renovation of part of your property for free seems like an impossible dream, though it became a reality for those lucky homeowners who appeared in any of the Crasher series. The truth is that the selection process involved in achieving that dream is quite hard. As it happens, there were of course many people wanting their courtyards renovated. This meant that to make the selection process less complex for the team, the Yard Crashers crew focused their search efforts mostly in California. Although they also traveled to other states in search of participants, but this didn't happen as often when the show rapidly gained popularity. On the bright side, any interested homeowners who weren't lucky enough to find the Yard Crashers team in their city's favorite stores had the opportunity to submit a volunteering petition to the DIY Network's website. While this method was probably not as effective as being picked in person, the small chance of appearing in any Crashers show was probably thrilling. Knowing how high its popularity was for several years, and that no new episodes haven't premiered for a while, it's only natural that the Yard Crashers audience wonder what happened to the show. Unfortunately, anything related to the future of Yard Crashers is uncertain. The series had been on air for a decade by 2017, when the DIY Network simply didn't renew it, but then refused to officially cancel it. The result is that Yard Crashers was left out in some sort of limbo, and so far, no one has confirmed what's going to happen to it. While there isn't anything confirmed so far, it's suspected that going through so many changes of hosts played a big role in the issue. As well, other shows from the Crashers franchise had been cancelled prior to it, due to budget cuts, which sounds like a strong possibility of explaining this situation. Either way, as long as Yard Crashers isn't cancelled, its fans shouldn't lose hopes of it returning to TV. Thank you for spending some time with us. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpick these videos which we recommend you watch next. You can talk to us on all social medias or ask a question in the comments below. Thank you for being with us, and we'll see you back tomorrow.